There's no going back from a mine, especially in this kind of ecosystem. It's a travesty anywhere, but in a place like this, I don't know if I can come up with a word that would describe how devastating it would be.
Well, I like to fish because it gets me time on the creek and time where I can be alone or just with a couple of friends. And getting out there and seeing the wildlife in the creek and learning how to fly fish, I feel like after 5 years, I'm still trying to figure out how to cast. Hunter Creek in particular is really special because it's a free-flowing stream. There's no dams. There's no hatchery influence, so all the fish are wild.
We are at the North Fork of the Smith. Upstream, several river miles, is the site of one of the proposed mines. The North Fork is such a beautiful and classic whitewater run. I'm Sunny Bourdon, and I am a river steward on the Chetco in the Smith. Well, my educational and professional background has been in fish and wildlife biology and doing spawning surveys in the winter, snorkel surveys in the summer for juvenile salmonids, and then some trapping efforts of young coho. The Smith is a crown jewel, a river of California, not only scenically, but also for its fisheries. We've got winter steelhead, chinook, we have coho, and coastal cutthroat, both sea run and resident. And there's even some resident rainbows that have decided to stay high up in the headwaters for whatever reason.
My name's James Smith, and we're at Archrock Brewing Company on Hunter Creek in Gold Beach, Oregon. I love Archrock because it's been my opportunity to build something of my own and create my own beer. The connection between water and beer and why it's important for me and Archrock is without clean water, I can literally not make the product that sustains our business, my livelihood, and the quality of our product.
When I heard about the permit to do exploratory drilling up Hunter Creek, I didn't know much about mining. It was hard to really grasp what that threat might look like if there was a problem until we had the Mount Poly disaster and the Animas River disaster. And that was two places that showed a lot of people what could happen here in Hunter Creek.
I was living up in Washington and returning home here to go kayaking. And I think that's when I first heard about the proposed mines. The mine up in the North Fork that would straddle both the North Fork of the Smith drainage and Rough and Ready Creek into the Illinois drainage is the most polluting mining activity there is.
The first thing that went through my head when Dave Lacey told me about the strip mine was this looming threat of breakouts of their slag water and all that rushing down to the brewery and killing native fish, ruining people's drinking water.
And the first thing I felt like I needed to do was gauge public perception on how people would feel about having a nickel mine up in their watershed. And so I went around and I created a petition and I walked it around Hunter Creek and started asking people, hey, what do you think about nickel mining? And pretty much everybody was on board with signing this petition to stop the mining up Hunter Creek. So when our delegation introduced the bill that started the mineral withdrawal process, there was a public comment period. And through that first public comment period, we generated over 40,000 comments, and we turned out more than 300 people to the Gold Beach meeting and over 250 people to the Grants Pass meeting.
It's a really heartwarming and impressive thing when the agencies that are running these hearings tell us that they've never had this kind of turnout.
So when I heard the 20-year mineral withdrawal happened, I was in disbelief and awe that our congressmen and all the people that stood up and fought and said no, that that worked. If we did not have the local support that we had, I do not believe that this would have gone through. It takes your local community to stand behind you. There's no one person in a giant fight for something that you believe in.
To hear that the 20-year mineral withdrawal got signed, I was ecstatic. It was awesome just to see all that work pay off, and during uneasy political times, to have a victory like this, it just feels great.
Through grassroots activism, so much can be done. Mountains can be moved, or in this case, mountains can be stopped from being moved.
When I go up Hunter Creek, there are no hatcheries. There are no dams. It feels like I'm in an unspoiled part of the country.
This mineral withdrawal will protect these amazing watersheds for 20 years, and it's over 100,000 acres of rogue siskiyou national forest. So it not only protects those public lands, but it protects the watersheds downstream. My name is Dave Lacey. I am a surfer, a fisherman, and a woodworker, and I'm the Native Fish Society River Steward for Hunter Creek.